गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द इंटर रिलेशन बिटवीन द डिफरेंट ऑर्गेनिज्म। सो स्टूडेंट्स, इंटरडिपेंडेंस बिटवीन डिफरेंट ऑर्गेनिजम्स इज ऑल्सो नोन एज द इकोलॉजिकल रिलेशनशिप विद अदर ऑर्गेनिजम्स। नाउ वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ इकोलॉजिकल रिलेशनशिप्स। बेसिकली वी हैव थ्री टाइप ऑफ इकोलॉजिकल रिलेशनशिप। वन इज नोन एज अ प्रेडेशन, second one is the symbiosis, and third one is the competition. So we will discuss them one by one. First of all, predation. Predation means in predation one prey is there and one predator is there. For example, in the food chain deer is a prey and lion is the predator, means which eat the prey, and prey is the organisms or the animal which are being eaten by the predator. Second one is the symbiosis. Two different species live in close association with each other is known as the symbiosis. Symbiosis is further divided into parasitism, mutualism and commensalism. So what is parasitism? Parasites, you know this term. One organisms affect negatively while other is benefited by this. In parasitism, one host is there whom the parasites usually live, and there are two types of parasites, ectoparasites and the endoparasites. Ectoparasites are the parasite which lives on the surface of host body. For example, ticks lives on the surface of dogs or other animals, and endoparasites which live inside the host body, such as some harmful amoebas or the flatworms, they are the endoparasites which live inside the host body. Now we will discuss about the mutualism. In mutualism, both the organisms get benefited. In parasitism, only one organism is benefited, other is harmed. But in mutualism, both the organisms are benefited. For example, you have studied about the rhizobium and the leguminous plants. Rhizobium bacteria is a nitrogen fixing bacteria which lives on the roots of leguminous plants such as pea, etc. And these rhizobium bacteria fixed the atmospheric nitrogen into nitrates which are used by the leguminous plants. And in the mutualism, leguminous plant gives shelter to the rhizobium plant, same as the clownfish and the sea anemone. Clownfish give shelter to the colonies of sea anemone, and in return clownfish is being protected by the sea anemone. So these are the example of the mutualism. Next one is the commensalism. In this relation, one organism's kind of commensal benefited from the other. The other organism is called host, means in commensalism, the commensal is benefited and the host is neither benefited nor harmed. So it is the opposite of the parasitism. For example, the remoras are marine fish that attach themselves to the large marine animals such as shark, whales, rays and turtles. And remoras are the commensals which feed on the leftover of the meals of the host, such as the sharks, whales, ray fish, etc. So apparently hosts do not get any harm, but the commensal is benefited. Next type of ecological relationship is competition. In competition, organisms compete with each other for food, water, space, air, light, etc. And there are two type of competition. What is intraspecific, other one is interspecific. Intraspecific means when two organisms compete within the same species. For example, lion and lion compete with each other for food. And interspecific means they compete with different species. For example, lion is competed with the wolf or some other carnivorous animals, means of different species. So these are the ecological interactions between the different organisms for food, shelter and other needs.